Welcome! In this series of short videos, we will give an introduction to those who have never used PowerBasic before or have even considered taking up programming. Today, we will look at numeric variables. In the development of your applications, you will encounter the requirement to do arithmetic calculations. Both the PowerBasic Windows and Console compilers provide a series of different types of numeric variable to assist you in your developments. So let's have a look at some code. In today's video, we're going to be using the PowerBasic Console compiler. There's no specific reason we have to use the Console compiler for today's video, but as we showed the Windows compiler in the last video, I thought we'd show the Console compiler today. What we have on screen is a variant of the Hello World application. We're declaring a local variable as a string. We have additionally added a command to turn the foreground color, the color of the text on a console, to be green. We're then populating our string variable with the words Hello World, and we're printing out to the screen that message. And then printing, press any key to exit the application, and then we're waiting for the user to press a key to exit the application itself. With the console compiler, since there is no dialogue to display on the screen for the user to click on, the console compiler, when it gets to the last line of code in the PB main function, the application would terminate. If we try running our application now, we'll see we get the Hello World message and the press any key to exit the application. What we're looking at today are numeric variables. Now, you may well ask, why have a separate set of variables just for numbers? Why not have one variable type that handles everything? That would be a good question. You remember in a previous video I talked about layers. What the user gets to see is the top level layer. What's happening under the hood can be quite different from what the user actually gets to see. The idea of having a variable type for text and a completely separate set of variable types for numbers is to do with what you're going to be doing with that variable later on in your application. Since a variable has been declared as a string, the application will not have to do any numerical calculations on that data. Whereas if a variable has been declared as a number, then it is in a format that can be more easily manipulated to do numerical calculations. So for the moment, we will comment out our population of the string variable, and we're going to set up a couple of number variables. As we said in the last video, you can name your variables more or less anything you want. However, it's quite handy to name your variables in a way that makes sense, so that when you're reading your code later, you can easily understand what the purpose of the variable is. So we've now renamed both of these variables, one to be age, as we're going to put an age in there, and one to be duration. And as we did in the previous video, we're going to specify in the name of the variable what kind of variable it actually is. This is a good point to talk about the different types of numeric variable. Again, to give the computer the best chance of actually manipulating your data correctly and efficiently, there are different types of numeric variable. The help file, which ships with PowerBasic, is very useful for seeing what the different commands and variable types actually are. There are quite a number of different types of variable in PowerBasic, but we're going to stick to one or two initially just to make it straightforward. If you need to keep track of whole numbers, that's numbers that have no decimal point or value after the decimal point, then you're looking at using a variable type which is an integer or a long. Now, since PowerBasic is a 32-bit system, you're best using long numbers. The reason for using long numbers as opposed to integers is that processing of long numbers goes faster in a 32-bit system. So we're going to concentrate on using long numbers. A long number, or effectively a long integer, is a whole number somewhere between a minus 2,000 million to a plus 2,000 million. This range of numbers is probably more than you will ever need. So we're going to declare our two variables as long, because these have no decimal point and are whole numbers. So as we did with the string variables, we can now set the value of both of these variables. With numeric variables, you merely have to use the name of the variable, an equal sign, and the value you wish to assign to it. Now with string variables, we had to enclose the text in double quotes. This is because text, of course, can contain spaces, punctuation marks, or basically any character. Whereas assigning the value to a numeric variable means you're giving it a number. Therefore, you don't need spaces or any punctuation marks. And as these are whole numbers, you merely have to just type the number. So we've assigned the value 21 to the age variable and the value 5 to the duration variable. So having got this information into these variables, what can we actually do with them? Well, if we wish to add both of these variables together and output to the screen what the addition of those variables were, we can do that quite simply. We can create a new variable to hold the addition of both of these other variables. We can do that quite easily by giving the name of the variable we wish to hold the new value equal to the addition of both of these variables. You could, of course, also use a subtraction or a multiplication or even a division. We'll cover those other operators later. So how do we know this value has actually been output? Well, let's put something out to our screen so we can see what the values are. Now, if we're going to print the age out to the screen, what we've done before is use the print command and a piece of text. Now, we're using the ampersand to add this together, but as this age variable is a numerical variable, we'll need to turn it into a string so that we can append it to the end of the other string. This can be done by a couple of different ways, but today we're just going to use the format command. The format command will take a numeric variable and turn it on the fly into a string so that it can be appended to the age equals string. It does not amend the value held within the age variable itself. It merely converts it temporarily so it can be added to the other string variable. So if we do exactly the same for the duration and the total variables to print all three out to the log. So let's have a look at it now. So there are our three variables. We have the age, which is currently holding a value of 21, the duration, which is holding a value of 5, and the total, which is the sum of the two other variables, which is 26. So when you're adding numeric variables together, you can use the plus sign. When you're adding strings together, normally I would use the ampersand. However, if you put the plus sign in instead, PowerBasic is intelligent enough to realize that you wish to append both of these strings together and it will still work. So if you look at some other people's code, you may occasionally see the plus sign rather than the ampersand. Personally, I prefer to use the ampersand to make it absolutely obvious when I'm reading the text that we were appending two strings together and we're not adding numeric variables. So since all three of these variables are long variables, they will have no component after the decimal point. They are indeed whole numbers. So what happens if we try to divide the age variable by the duration variable? What value would we actually get? We can find out the answer to that question by printing these out to our console. In this case, I'm not putting the value into another variable. I'm actually just printing out the result. I'm taking the age, dividing it by the duration, and turning the output of that calculation into a string. So if we run that now, the value would be 4.2. Now you might think that's strange because we're doing a calculation on two whole number variables. However, we're not putting the value into a third variable. Therefore, PowerBasic will allow two numbers to be divided and will give you the answer exactly as it would appear in the calculation. If we had stored that value in another long variable, it would appear just as 4, because a long variable cannot hold the value of a decimal point. So it would either round up or round down the value. But using this mechanism, you can actually find out the real value of the calculation. So if we wanted to go a little further and work out what the percentage of the age that the duration actually is, we could do that again on one line of code by taking the duration divided by the age, and we would enclose that in single brackets to ensure that calculation is done first, multiply that by 100 and give us a percentage sign. Now you'll see here that it has actually calculated this to quite a number of decimal places, as it's roughly 24%, 23.8 and quite a number of decimal places. Now you may not always want that number of decimal places displayed on the screen. So how can we actually reduce that to just, for example, 2 decimal places? Well, we will create a new variable to store the result. Now we're declaring this percentage variable as a single. As you will see from the help file, the single precision floating point variable is a specific type of variable designed to look after values which have a particular range to 6 digits. So let's try this and let's see what the result we get. So we're going to do the calculation in the line here. We're going to populate the single percentage variable with the calculation. And then we're going to use the format command to put that out to our console. So if we try running this now, we'll see we get 23.8 and we'll get a fewer number of decimal places. Now this is getting towards where we want to be, but it's not perfect yet. So how can we reduce this so we only have 2 decimal places? Well, one mechanism is to use the round command. The round command is to round a numeric value to a specified number of decimal places. It takes 2 parameters, the expression we wish to round, and the second parameter is the number of decimal places we want to go to. So in order to achieve this, we're using the round command, and within the brackets we have the name of the variable we wish to round, and the second parameter is a number to say how many decimal places we wish to round this value to. So if we try running that code now, we'll see that the percentage is now coming out with 2 decimal places. So we have looked so far at 2 different types of numeric variable. The long variable, which is used to hold whole numbers, and the single variable, which is used to hold numbers with a decimal point and value after the decimal point. So basically it can hold whole numbers and fractions. If the value of the variable is always going to be a whole number, it's best to use the long variable type. If the value is going to contain numbers after the decimal point, then use the single type of variable. Now there are other types of variable which we'll cover in later videos, but briefly they are the quad integer. Now quad is an 8-byte signed integer which contains twice as many bits as a long. Therefore it can hold some seriously large numbers. But again, as they are whole numbers, there'll be no decimal point held. So if you wish a value to be held that has a decimal point and values after the decimal point, and the single variable type does not have enough precision for you, you can use the double variable type. The double variable type is a floating point number system which is much bigger and has a greater range than the single. So when you're storing information within variables of a numeric type, it pays to take a little time to work out how big is that number going to be, or is it going to be a whole number or not a whole number. But that about covers our introduction to numeric variables. In our next video, we will start to look at arrays of numbers and arrays of strings. But that's it for today. Thank you for watching.